Yeah, so I will start today about the uses of Git we use in our daily life while doing the programming and all pushing the codes to Git repos like GitHub, GitLab, or Bitbucket. So we used to push the codes on different platforms. Which maintain repositories of the projects, but in most of the cases, sometimes what happens, the developer face some issue with code push. Sometimes they face some issues while configuring the Git and some ignoring files and switching the branches. Are creating the new branch, removing some files from remote repository. So I will go through that some basic commands we use in our daily life. So we'll start with first Git install. So if you are a Debian user, maybe you will get the pre-installed Git, but if it's not having and you are on Ubuntu or Ubuntu, you can install it by sudo apt-get install git, or you can run the command sudo apt-install git. It will install the Git client for you. And next step, we come for configuration. For Windows, I think they're already given one exe file which gives two types of uses. One is GUI and one is command line. So there is one exe file already given on the given for Git. You need to download. I will give the download link in my video, and also I will give the cheat sheet used for Git operations in our daily life. So after installation, configuration comes in picture. Like need to configure the Git on your system as a global. Then, if you open the command line and you already installed the Git, you have to run git config hyphen hyphen global. Username, you need to fill your username something like Roger Taylor or something else. You can fill your name. And next is to configure the email address. So you have to run the command git config hyphen hyphen global. User.email. This email belongs to your Git account, or maybe GitLab account, or maybe GitHub account, or maybe Bitbucket. This will belong to there. So once you configure this, you are ready to do the operations with Git. Next is starting a project. If you are going to start a new project, or if you have already project in Git repo and you are going to start with that, then you have to go for clone. If you are going to start a new project, you create your project folder or init there, run the command git init and a project name. It will initialize one dot git folder. It will hold the information about your current project initialization. Let me show you. If once you have configured the Git, you can run the simple command git config hyphen hyphen list. This will give you the current configuration, like I have said. Like in configuration, you have to set the username and email as global. So I have listed here this command also. So this is showing like credential helper is. OS kitchen user.name is equal to Ramkrishna and user.email is ramkrishna70@lab.com. Credential helper is OXM again. So this my Git is configured with my username and my email. So moving to next, I have added here the links of downloads from where you can download the Git. Or you can download the GUI versions as well. So GUI version will appear like this. I have just installed it on my system. So GUI version will look like this. I create new repo, clone existing, open existing repository, so it will look like this. Some person use GUI version and few use command line. I always prefer command line. It's up to you how you are going to use it. So when you start a project, you created a project, you go to that project directory and run this git init project name. It will initialize the empty git. And later you add the git add remote URL from where you want to add this git. If you are going to remove any file from git, you just run this git rm file name. If you are going to work with existing project, you have to clone the existing project, like git clone with project URL. Will be something GitHub, GitLab, some project name.git, like that. So you can clone that and you start working. Now come to day-to-day work in here we stuck some time. So first of all, whenever we open our system for any change detection, first we have to list out if any change left out previous day which haven't committed it. So just run git status, it will give the list what are the files you have not committed so far. If you want to add any file which you need to push in the repo, you just need to add git add file name you can add, or if you run this as git add dot slash, it will add the current directory. Whatever changes you have made so far, it will add the new modified files or newly added files in git change list. If you want to defer a file from remote and from your local change, so you can run this git diff file name. This will compare with the remote and your local changes, it will show as well. This is same for a staged. If you have already staged your file, like you have added all your file, you can compare with this hyphen hyphen staged. If you are going to check out any file, you can check out like git checkout hyphen hyphen file name. You can also check out a single file. Get reset. Sometime when what happens, we modify in our local system and we face conflict and want to reset the changed file. So you can run this as a git reset file name. Git commit is known for all, most of the person know git commit. So git commit is to commit the code, whatever you have done the changes, with one commit message. This is git commit minus m is stands for message, and you have to pass like what you are going to commit or whatever you have made the changes. You have to name the change write in a message. The proper way to write a message is first you write in a notepad and just pass here as inside inverted comma, so that you can specify different things. Whatever changes you have made, you can specify it here. And next come is git push. Once you committed, your changes are staged to go to remote server. So once you run the git push, it will start uploading your local changes to the remote git. So this is the day-to-day work like thing. Now coming to git branching model, how can we create a branch, how we can switch a branch and all. So if you give a command like git branch name, it will create a branch for you. And if you are going to check out a branch, existing branch or a new branch, so you can run with option B. When you run git checkout hyphen B branch name, if that branch name exists, it will just check out that. If doesn't exist, it will create one new branch for you and then it will check out. This is the option B work. So now coming to ignore file, you can see in this project, like let me minimize it. Yeah, so you can see it here. Like this there are a lot of files like user config and environment config json git ignore file is there one which I am going to explain it. Its extension is dot git ignore, which holds some files. But why I need to put here? Suppose I have to push this whole code base to git repo. So I don't want to push this plugin platform node modules because these are not required whenever someone will take the checkout of this project. So when he or she will run the npm install, all the dependencies will be stored in node modules, and when he or she will run the platform add or plugin add, it will be stored in this folder. So these are dynamically system dependent, so no need to push this in git. So I have kept here as git ignore, something git ignore, where I am ignoring some files, like whatever files I need to ignore it. I can see node module I am ignoring, dist I am ignoring. I need to also ignore this source map as well. So I will ignore the source map as well. Now I will also ignore the plugins. I will also ignore the platforms. Yeah, platforms. So when I will make commit, these changes will not be taken by git. So this is ignoring git file, git files. So what are the things I have to ignore. Now when you go back at reset, yeah, here when you have done few local changes and you are facing a bit conflict, in that case I have force git pull to overwrite local changes. Long time back I was facing issue, so I have written here force git pull to override the local files. Step to do this: fetch all branches. This is git fetch all. This will fetch all the branches, whatever branches you have, and whatever branches you are working on, you can just run git reset hard with hyphen hyphen hard origin and branch name master. If I am going to write with master, I will pass here the master. If I am going to write with main, with I'll pass here main. And next is same, just I am giving the whatever branch name. You can specify here. Here's few explanation has been given: git fetch download the latest from remote without trying to merge or rebase anything. Then git reset resets the master branch or whatever branch you have passed here to what you just fetched. The hard option changes all the files in your working tree to match the files in origin master, that is remote. So this is one specific I have written. Sometimes I forgot it, so I take a reference from here. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon. Thank you.